Alright, I'm Hank, and this is CBMF. Today, we're doing a little bit of San Diego Comic-Con trailer breakdowns. See, I gotta admit, I love superhero movies. Or rather, I love the idea of them. I love the idea of seeing characters from comic books manifesting in the real world. Watching illustrations come alive and getting to imagine that we live in such a world. A world with superheroes and villains and vigilantes all in crazy costumes with strange powers and abilities unlike normal folks. Sadly, it often seems that just having science fiction or superheroes in your story does kind of diminish the quality of the writing. You wind up with plots that dictate the choices of the characters rather than the other way around. In the real world, characters dictate the majority of plots, for the most part. And that's what I prefer to see in my movies. Natural behavior, and plots being dictated by strong character choices. Anyways, forget all that shit. They announced a bunch of news and released a bunch of trailers at San Diego Comic-Con this weekend, and I thought I'd dish on what's developing from my own, albeit unique, perspective. Let's talk about the squad first. I'm weirdly intrigued by the Suicide Squad movie. It's developing a lot of momentum as it sells itself more and more as the sort of dark yet bright kind of material I enjoy. It's reminiscent of Deadpool without looking like it's trying to squeeze into his costume. The more I see of the characters, the more I like them all. The more I see the action, the better it all looks. I feel like there's a few takes where I can legit see how much fun these actors are having, just being in crazy costumes and hanging out with a big team of big-shot performers. That's almost a distraction, to be honest, but it still imbues the whole thing with an energy that I gotta admit I'm kinda catching on to. Luke Cage. I will have a lot to say about Luke once his show is out. For the trailer, I was impressed with the action, but that's about all they showed us. And with Luke, I'm far more interested in his character. I know who I think Luke Cage is based on the comic books I've read, and I'm interested in seeing what they kept, what they abandoned, and what they chose to introduce. As a series, Luke Cage looks great, but he's also one of my longtime favorite characters, and I'm really scared that he's not ever going to get to be as cool on screen as he is in my head. In my head, Luke Cage is the coolest motherfucker in fiction. He's the perfect combination of badass motherfucker and a really nice guy who cares about his community. I think of him as a friendly, open-hearted guy who ain't afraid of anything. And I hope that's what I see in the show. Iron Fist. Just a tiny bit of footage, not much to judge on. I was hoping to see the mask or the costume or even the tattoo, but maybe later. What we got is a silly kid looking like a bit of a bum. Whatever, lots of time for that one to evolve. Doctor Strange. Not a bad trailer, but not an exceptional one either. It certainly didn't make me want to see the movie, not that it turned me away, but there was nothing interesting to me in it. Aside from what I know in the comics, the trailer didn't tell me anything about Stephen Strange, and it didn't give me any reason to care about him. It was basically a trailer that showed its special effects, and then danced away. Even then, the effects are nothing too spectacular. I mean, if they were practical effects, maybe I'd be impressed, but just seeing CG illustrations spinning around doesn't do much for me. I'm still really interested in Doctor Strange, but again, mostly because of my history with the comics. Justice League. Now, this was a big one. Seeing Flash and Batman interact on screen was pretty cool, and I like the tone and the visual design of it all. At the same time, it suffered from some odd pacing issues, like too many hands had been involved in cutting the trailer together, and a lot of the beats just didn't land right, as interesting as they were. Aquaman reminds me a lot of the Marvel Cinematic Thor. Sexy macho guy with long hair smashes a drinking beverage on the ground. I've seen this before, right?
This drink, I like it.
I know, it's great, right?
Another!
Whenever Aquaman is doing stuff on screen, I can almost hear a nervous executive screaming, "This ain't your daddy's Aquaman!" while a wild guitar solo plays in the background. It's so hip and edgy that it's kind of silly. Not nearly enough Cyborg in the trailer, but I think his character is mostly CG, so they probably won't have his footage ready until the movie is almost good to go. Ben seems almost younger in his Bruce Wayne mode, and I like the idea that this Bruce Wayne isn't famous. In the comics, everybody around the world has heard of billionaire Bruce Wayne. He's like Donald Trump or Lex Luthor. I like the idea that this Bruce Wayne is a quiet recluse, and that there's a lot of people who don't even realize that he's the Wayne of Wayne Enterprise. Justice League looks good, but it also has a crazy musical choice for its trailer. I can't name the tune, but it has this real, like, 70s jamming on guitar feel to it. It's not a bad choice, just a very strange one. It kind of reminded me a lot of Slow Ride by Foghat, which is a very odd song to be reminded of when you're watching a Justice League trailer. Wonder Woman. People fell in love with this one. And I'm people. It was a great trailer. It introduced the story and the character, set up a fantasy world you could believe in, and then smashed that fantasy into reality. Being mostly a Marvel guy in my youth, I'm not super familiar with Wonder Woman. I probably know her best from Grant Morrison's JLA run. She's one of those old-timey characters like Captain America that I've never really had much time for. In this trailer, though, she seemed strong, both of physical force and will, and she seemed like her own person. It didn't feel like she was even being played for laughs or treated visually as a sexual object. She is the hero of her movie, and it looks like her movie is going to treat her with that respect. I'm not sure if I'm going to go see it, but it looks very well made, and it sounds like a number of people I know were very emotionally stirred by it. So that's a good thing. Legion. The last one on my list is Legion, the X-Men spin-off TV series that's being produced by Noah Hawley, who is the showrunner on FX's Fargo TV series. Also, I think I'm saying his name wrong. Anyway, that's why I'm talking about this one now. Season 1 of Fargo was incredible, and Season 2 of Fargo was one of the best things I've ever seen on TV. So the idea that that creative talent is going to be digging into the X-Men mythology is very attractive to me. X-Men was my jam as a young man, though I've never been too close to Legion. I think this series will take a lot of liberties with his backstory, and I don't mind that. What's important is that it's a clever-looking show that takes place in a world that has mutants in it. Not the X-Men necessarily, but mutants for sure. I am painfully curious to see what kind of world-building they're going to do in that series. How much we'll hear the word mutant and how they'll be portrayed. If we're even going to see some existing mutants that we know from the mythos, like outside of Legion, who they're going to be and what they can afford to use. Honestly, I'm usually a creator-first kind of guy. That's what I care the most about in any project, is who's making it. What company, what writer, what director. After that, you get into who and what it's about, but all that shit's secondary to me. Legion is a perfect example of that, for me. I care about the creator of this project. If you took him away, I probably wouldn't even be talking about Legion right now. I mean, there's a pretty cool cast, and it is a mature audience X-Men TV show, and that's all cool. But the reason I'm interested in Legion is because Fargo Season 2 was so goddamn good it almost broke my heart. And I cannot wait to see what that series creator will do in a science fiction setting. And not just any sci-fi setting, but one that I was in love with as a younger fan. Will Legion live up to any of this? It's hard to say, but I got a good feeling about it. Anyway, that's just my little take on what came out of San Diego Comic-Con this weekend. I'm Hank, and this has been CBMF. Thanks for watching. We'll be seeing you.